السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In previous lecture, we solved question number 7 and 8 of practice set. Question number 7 and 8 of practice set 3.1. And today we are going to continue practice set 3.1, the remaining two questions. Okay?
Practice set 3.1, question number 9 is, using the information given in the figure, find the measure of angle A, angle B and angle C. Here some informations are given in the figure and we have to observe the information given in the figure and find the value of angle A and angle B and angle C. Now see in the figure, two angles are given to you, one is 70 degree and one is 100 degree, and you have to find the measure of angle A, B and C. If you observe carefully, then you can find angle B and 70 degree, they are the vertically opposite angle, and we know that the vertically opposite angles are congruent. So value of angle B is 70 degree as they are the vertically opposite angle. Now observe here, C and 100 degree, they are the linear pair of angle, and we know that the linear pair of angles are supplementary, that means their sum is 180. So angle C plus 100 is equal to 180. So angle C and 100 degree are the linear pair of angle, and we discussed in previous class linear pair of angles are supplementary, that means their addition is 180. So therefore angle C plus 100 degree is equal to 180. So you get the value of angle C, 180 minus 100 degree is 80 degree. Okay, so angle B is 70 degree and angle C is 80 degree. Now the last angle A, you can find the angle A by using sum of angle of a triangle is 180. That means angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180. You are having the value of angle B 70 degree and value of angle C is 80 degree. So you can find the value of angle A. This question is for you. Practice this question, solve it. Okay. Check your answer here. Angle C 80 degree, angle A 30 degree, angle B 70 degree. Yes? Okay.
So the question number 10 is, given line DE is parallel to GF. Line DE here parallel to GF. These two lines are parallel given to you. DE is parallel to GF. And ray EG, this EG is the bisector of angle DEF, okay? And ray FG is the bisector of angle DFN, okay? And you have to prove that DEG, that means this angle DEG is half of angle EDF. And second, you have to prove EF is equal to FG. Okay. Once again, see here. These two lines are parallel given to you. DE and GF are the parallel lines. And EG is the bisector of this angle E, that means DEF. And GF is the bisector of angle DFM. Okay. And we have to prove DEG angle is half of angle EDF. And second, you have to prove EF is equal to FG. Okay. So let's start from bisector. EG is the bisector of angle DEF. EG is the bisector of angle DEF. So let's start your proof. Proof. EG is the bisector of angle DEF. EG is the bisector of angle DEF, and you know the angle bisector property. Angle bisector divide an angle into equal angles. So therefore angle DEG, angle DEG equal, or you can say that congruent to GEF, angle GEF, angle bisector property. Let's suppose, I suppose this angle as x degree. So angle DEG equal to angle GEF is equal to x degree. Okay. So your whole angle DEF x plus x 2x degree. So therefore, angle DEF is nothing but x plus x 2x. Okay. Give it number 1. Now give here number 1 and give this. Give here number 1 and this is number 2. This is number 2. Okay. Now they said line DE is parallel to GF. Okay. Line DE is parallel to GF. And you know the parallel line concept. If the lines are parallel, then the corresponding angles formulate, alternate angles formulate, interior angles are supplementary. So start DE, line DE is parallel to line GF. Okay. Line DE and GF are parallel, so EG is a transversal. Line GE is transversal. Okay. Now see here, if these two lines are parallel, then this angle and this angle, corresponding angles below the parallel line, they are the corresponding angles and corresponding angles are congruent. So therefore, angle DEF, angle DEF is congruent to angle GFM. Angle GFM. They are the corresponding angles. Okay. So as angle DEF 2x degree, so GFM is also 2x degree. So as angle DEF is equal to 2x degree, so therefore angle GF, so angle GFM, angle GFM is also 2x degree. Give it number 3. Okay, now got it. Now FG is the bisector of angle DFM, and bisector divide the angle into equal angles. So FG is the bisector of angle DFM. DFM. So therefore, the angles DFG and GFM. So therefore, angle DFG equal to angle or congruent to the angle GFM by angle bisector property. Okay. So by angle bisector property. So here GFM 2x degree, so therefore DFG is also 2x degree. So therefore angle DFG is equal to angle GFM, both are equal to 2x degree. Got it? So your whole angle DFM, whole angle DFM, this angle is 2x degree, this angle is 2x degree. So whole angle is 4x degree. So therefore angle DFM, DFM is 2x plus 2x, that is 4x degree. Got it? Give it number 4. Okay? So your whole angle DFM, 2x plus 2x is 4x degree. Here we suppose this angle as x and x. Got it? Now let's move to the next part. If you observe, DFM is the exterior angle of this triangle. And you know the property of exterior angle. Exterior angle is equal to the sum of remote interior angles. So angle DFM is exterior angle of triangle DEF. Triangle DEF. So by the theorem of remote interior angle. So by the theorem of remote interior angle. So by the theorem of remote interior angles, exterior angle DFM is equal to sum of its remote interior angles. So your remote interior angles are this and this. That is angle EDF and plus angle EDF plus angle DEF. Angle EDF plus angle DEF. Okay. Now substitute the value. DFM Angle DFM we are having 4x degree. Angle EDF we are not having the any value. Now angle DEF. See here DEF we are having 2x degree. Okay. So 2x, 4x minus 2x is 2x. So therefore angle EDF. Angle EDF is equal to 4x minus 2x. So angle EDF is equal to 2x degree. Got it? Give it number 5. Now write here 4x and 2x are from 2 and 4. From 2 and 4. Okay. EDF is 2x degree. We get the value of angle EDF. That means this angle is 2x degree. Now you want DEG. DEG half of angle EDF. So x value. See here x degree value. In place of x you can write DEG. That DEG you want. So in place of x you can write DEG. So write angle EDF is equal to 2 times angle EDG. Okay. So in place of x you can write angle DEG. Okay. Write here from 1. In place of angle EDF that you want angle EDF. It's half of angle DEG. So see here in place of X you can write angle DEG. Okay. In place of X you can write angle DEG because angle DEG value is X degree. So write here angle DEF. Angle EDF is equal to 2 into. In place of X you can write angle DEG. Angle DEG. Okay. So write here from 1. From 1. 2 here in multiply that side goes in divide. So angle DEG is equal to half of angle EDF. Half of angle EDF. The same thing you have to prove. Angle DEG is equal to half of angle EDF. Okay. So here you prove your first. Now the second you have to prove here. EF, that means this side is equal to GF. EF is equal to FG. These two sides you have to prove as equal. Now observe here, if these two lines are parallel, then these are the alternate angle. And you know that the alternate angles are congruent. If this angle is X degree, then automatically this angle is also X degree. So let's start the second part. Line DE is parallel to GF. Line DE parallel to line GF and EG is transversal. Line EG is transversal. Okay. So therefore the angle DEG is congruent to EGF. Angle DEG is congruent to angle GEF. They are the alternate angles. Okay. Angle DEG value is X degree. Angle DEG value is X degree. So therefore angle EGF value is also X degree. So therefore angle DEG is equal to angle GEF is equal to X degree from 1. Okay. If these two angles are equal, then automatically this triangle is an isosceles triangle. So by isosceles triangle, EF is equal to GF. So therefore, EF is equal to GF isosceles triangle property. Okay. So this is your second part. Got it? Now let's repeat one more time. See here in this figure, as per the figure, these two lines are parallel and EG is the EG is the bisector of angle DEF and FG is the bisector of angle DFM. And you have to prove DEG. DEG angle is half of angle EDF. EDF, and second you have to prove EF is equal to GF. Okay. So to prove this theorem, I start with the bisector property. The first one is EG is the bisector of angle DEF. EG is the bisector of angle DEF. So due to the bisector, I angle divide into equal angle. So therefore, angle DEG is congruent to angle GEF by bisector. I suppose these two angles as x degree. So here these two angles are x degree and x degree. Okay. Now next is, these two lines are parallel. So your whole angle DEF, your whole angle is x plus x is 2x degree. Here I given here number 1, that is number 2. Now these two lines are parallel. So EG is the transversal. So line DE is parallel to line GE. So line GE is the transversal. Line DE is parallel to line GF. Line DE is parallel to line GF and GE is the transversal. So due to this parallel line, this angle and this angle is the corresponding angle. Okay. So therefore angle DEF is congruent to GFM by corresponding angle. Okay. So if angle DEF is 2x degree, then automatically angle GFM is also 2x degree because to both the angles are congruent. Okay. Now once again they have given FG is the bisector of this angle. Again the angle bisector property, angle bisector divide angle to angle equal. So due to this bisector, the two angles are DFG and GFM. Both are congruent. Okay. If this angle, that means GFM, is 2x degree, then automatically both the angles are 2x degree. So whole angle DFM is 2x plus 2x, 4x degree. Okay. Give it number 4. Okay. Now then I apply the property of exterior angle. I observe DFM is the exterior angle of this triangle. And we know that the property of remote interior angle, exterior angle is equal to the sum of its remote interior angle. So therefore angle DFM, that means exterior angle, is equal to remote interior angle, that means EDF plus DEF. Okay. So I am having the value of DFM 4x degree. I'm having the value of DEF 2x degree. So I substituted the value. 4x minus 2x is 2x degree. Okay. Then I observe here what we have to prove. I have to prove here DEG angle is half of EDF. I'm having EDF. I want DEG. Then I observe here EDG angle. That means EDF. I'm having here EDF angle. I want DEG. Then I observe angle DEG is x degree. So in place of x degree, I can write angle DEG. Okay. Now 2 here in multiply, that side goes in divide. So angle DEG is half of angle DEDF. So that is your first part. Now to prove second part, again I observe these two lines are parallel and this is the transversal. So therefore these angles in the form of Z, they are the alternate angles and we know that the alternate angles are congruent. So therefore angle EDEG is congruent to angle GFM. Okay, by alternate angle. If this angle is x degree, automatically this angle is also x degree. So the triangle become isosceles triangle. If the angles are congruent, then the sides are congruent. So by isosceles triangle property, your side EF is congruent, that is equal to GF. Okay. Let's repeat one more time. I know this question is a little bit difficult. So let's repeat one more time here. Here first of all observe the given part. The given is these two lines are parallel. That means line DE is parallel to line GF. Okay. And they have given EG is the bisector of this angle. That means angle DEF. And FG is the bisector of angle DFM. Okay. So first of all I start with the bisector property. That is EG is the bisector of angle DEF. And you know the angle bisector property, angle bisector divide the angle to equal angle. So therefore let's start your proof. EG is the bisector of angle DEF. Okay. So due to this EG, the two angles are divided. One is DEG and the second is GEF. Okay. And I suppose the measure of these two angles is x degree. Okay. Now then your whole angle DEF, DEF is nothing but the x plus x is 2x degree, give it number 2. Okay. Now the next part, I observe these two lines are parallel. That means line DE is parallel to line GF. Okay. If these two lines are parallel, then these two angles, that means this angle and this angle, are the corresponding angles. And you know that the corresponding angles are congruent. So angle DEF is congruent to angle GFM by corresponding angle. So as angle DEF we proof as 2x degree, so GFM is also 2x degree. Okay. So now the next property, give it number 3. Next property, FG. FG is the bisector of angle DFM. Okay. FG is the bisector of angle this angle. So this FG divide the angle into equal angle. So therefore angle DFG is equal to GFM by angle bisector property. Angle DFG is congruent to angle GFM by angle bisector property. DFG and GFM we have proved 2x degree. So that's why both the angles are equal to 2x degree. As they are congruent, as they are divided by angle bisector. So angle bisector divide the angle to equal angles. So both are the 2x degree. Now your whole angle DFM is nothing but 2x plus 2x, 4x degree. Got it? Give it number 4. Then I observe this angle DFM is the exterior angle of this triangle. And you know the property of remote interior angle theorem. That is, exterior angle is equal to sum of remote interior angle. So your exterior angle DFM is equal to remote interior angle, that is angle D and angle E. So I write here three letter name, EDF plus DEF. Now substitute the value. We are having the value of angle DFM 4x degree. We are having the value of DEF is as 2x degree. So I substituted. So 4x minus 2x is 2x degree. So you get angle EDF is 2x degree. Now observe here, we want angle DEG half of angle EDF. We are having EDF, but in place of x we want DEG. Then I observe here, okay, angle DEG is nothing but x degree. So in place of x degree, I replace angle DEG as angle DEG value is x degree. Now 2 here in multiply, that side goes in divide. So angle DEG is half of angle EDF. Here we prove our first part. Now the second part, they have given these two lines are parallel. And this is the transversal. So these are the alternate angles, and alternate angles are congruent. So angle DEG is congruent to angle GEF by angle by alternate angles. Okay. This angle DEG and angle GFM. Angle DEG and angle EGF are the alternate angle. And you can say that the angle DEG is congruent to angle GEF. They are the alternate angle and alternate angles are congruent. If this angle is x degree, automatically this angle is also x degree as both are congruent. Okay. Now, so therefore this triangle become isosceles triangle. In isosceles triangle, if base angles are equal, then opposite sides are also equal. So therefore EF is equal to GF by isosceles triangle property. Okay. So here we solve question number 10. I know this question is little bit difficult, but it needs practice. Just practice 2-3 times. Here we apply the 2-3 properties simultaneously. First of all, we apply the property of angle bisector. Then we apply the property of parallel lines. Then we apply the property of again angle bisector. And then we apply the property of remote interior angle theorem. And apply the property of parallel lines. So, 2-3 properties we are applied here in one question simultaneously. So just practice this question. It means just practice 2-3 times. Then you feel easy. It's not too much difficult. It's little bit difficult. It just need a practice. Okay. Practice is easy question and important for 4 marks. Okay. This question is important for 4 marks. Prepare for exam. It can be asked for exam. I'm not sure it will ask or not. But prepare it for 4 marks. Okay. In next lecture, we will start practice step 3.2. So practice all the question of 3.1. So we will, in unit test, I will ask only question number, lesson number 1, lesson number 2 and practice step 3.2. For unit test, lesson 1, lesson 2 and practice step 3.1, that much. Okay. Practice all the questions. Best of luck for exam. In next lecture, we will start practice set 3.2. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Take care. Jazakallahu khair.